Hi there, this video outlines an operon system and I'm using an inducible example. The classic example that's used is the lac operon system. So if we look at a segment of DNA, we can locate where the genes are, but there's sort of a control mechanism in bacteria that sort of precedes that, that triggers the enzymes in the cell that yes, we want to transcribe and translate this particular protein, or no, we're going to keep it shut down, we don't need it right now. This is a response system, so often these are catabolic type pathways because it will change when that substrate becomes available. So if there's a particular, for example, carbohydrate to break down, that system will be triggered to turn on so that you're synthesizing the enzymes to break down that particular molecule. So there's a region kind of on the back that gets ignored a little bit, but that's the regulatory or repressor synthesis region. And it's often with an I, kind of for relates to that inducible aspect that's there. So when I'm drawing this sort of tube here, this is that double strand of DNA. We're just looking at one part of it. Okay, one side of that double strand. So next to that, you'll have a what's called a P or promoter region. And then next to that, you have an operon region. I'm just trying to kind of keep my colors a little bit consistent here. And that's where the control occurs. And then following that, you may have one or more sets of these are the actual genes, the structural genes. These are the genes that are going to actually make the functional protein that you're interested in. So I'm using a three protein system here because that's commonly used in the lactose system. So when you talk about the enzyme just lactase, you're usually talking about a group of enzymes. It's a complex of enzymes. So, but often if you're taking lab, just wanted to mention, you'll just call that lactase collectively, but it actually is made up of multiple genes that code for different enzymes related to lactose breakdown or digestion. Okay, so very quickly here, there's a control region, and I've kind of covered up here where I wanted to draw, so I'm going to erase a little bit. There's a control region at that operon region, and there's a molecule there called the repressor that binds to it. So the repressor is synthesized back at that I region there. That's where the information, because you can't put it in here because that's where the control is. So you need to kind of make that repressor independent of that. So the genes to synthesize that would go through transcription and translation over here, and you make something called a repressor. And so the repressor is a protein that can bind to the operon itself. So if you remember what the enzyme is that manufactures messenger RNA or is responsible for catalyzing the synthesis of messenger RNA, it's RNA polymerase. So RNA polymerase will attempt, deciding on my colors here, RNA polymerase will bind here an attempt to do transcription, but what happens is it bumps into the repressor protein. Let me label that. That's our repressor protein. So this is the off version. Of the system. So you aren't able to make messenger RNA. Okay, so now let's quickly draw this again. We're gonna show what the on version looks like. So there's that I region, followed by that promoter region. I'm gonna do a little bit of shorthand here, operator. Whoops, and that should say operator. The operon refers to the whole system as a whole. That's the operator. Okay, so has the O here, and then followed by those structural genes. These are the actual genes that you're interested in. So when lactose, the sugar lactose, becomes available in the cell, and other sugar systems have other operon systems as well, other sugars have their own operon system, so lactose is just one version here. So what will happen is this repressor will have that particular sugar. And if you look at the details, lactose is a small amount of it's changed to something called allolactose, but it will actually bind to the repressor. So here's our repressor again. And it will cause the shape to change a little bit here. And I'm going to write lactose. It's really allolactose, so bear with me. If you're looking at all those details. And it will cause the repressor to come off of the operon system. So now when RNA polymerase arrives, it's able to move on down. There's nothing blocking it anymore. So there's actually a conformational change depending on whether lactose is present or not. And then when the concentration of lactose gets low because the bacteria has broken down all the lactose that's available, the substrate will come off of the repressor and it will bend back into that repressor stage and it will go back on to the, bind back to the operator and shut the system back down. So what will happen is RNA polymerase will move along here. You'll make your mRNA, and then you'll make your proteins. And there's a list there that are associated with the lactase system like beta galactosidase that help enhance either lactose coming over the membrane or breaking down the lactose. So again, just to review, in an inducible system, it's actually typically in the off position. Once that particular substrate becomes available, it will be turned on. So here's our on position, our on version. And the way it does that is that lactose binds to that repressor protein. This is a protein here. And it will cause it to bend or change in some way, change the shape. We know proteins work very specifically based on the shape that they're folded into that will come off of the operator. And I kind of abbreviate here. Your RNA polymerase will move along here, will read the A, T, C's, and G's, make your messenger RNA and transcription, and then go through translation into proteins. So that's basically the system here. There's some nice animation videos that are good to watch with that as well. I strongly encourage that. There is a repressible system that's talked about as well that's not covered here. It works the same way with the layout. However, when the substrate is present, it actually activates the system. So it's just a little opposite on how the repressor responds to the substrate. But the general flow is the same. If the repressor is bound to the operator, the RNA polymerase cannot proceed and go through transcription and translation. That's all I have on this. I thank you very much. Please contact me with any questions you have. This is Corey Andres at Central New Mexico Community College using CNN.